الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي
Respected brothers in Islam and the listeners, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. On the 15th para, Surah Isra, Allah Rabbul Izzat says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Do they not see that surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created the skies and the earth? قَادِرٌ عَلَىٰ أَن يَخْلُقَ مِثْلَهُمْ And he is capable of creating the same. وَجَعَلَ لَهُمْ أَجَلًا لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given a limited time for every person's life. فَأَبَى الظَّالِمُونَ إِلَّا كُفُورًا But the infidels, they refused to accept this. كُلُّ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي إِذَا لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ Say to them, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَوْ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي That if you have the possession of the rahmat and the ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذَا لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ Then you would not spend anything with the fear of keeping it to yourself with the fear of this getting expended. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ قَطُورًا. An insan is but a miser. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى تِسْعَ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ. And we have given Musa alayhi salatu wasalam 9 signs of ours. فَاسْأَلْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ. And ask the children of Bani Israel when came upon them our messenger. فَقَالَ لَهُ فِرْعَوْنَ. Then Pharaoh of Egypt said to him, إِنِّي لَأَزُنُّكَ يَا مُوسَى مَسْحُورًا. O Musa, I feel the jadu and black magic was done upon you. This is the translation of this ayah karima. And we have been doing this over the past 30 odd years, starting from Surah Fatiha. We have come to the point of Surah Bani Israel. Previously, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the kuffar, that how on the day of Qiyamah they will be lifted up on this, on the day of Qiyamah, from this dunya in such a manner that they will be blind. وَنَحْشُرُهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِهِمْ عُمْيَوْا وَبُكْمَهُمْ وَصُمَّا. That they will be deaf and they will also be dumb. مَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ. And their place will be in Jahannam. And Allah Rabbul Izzat in this week's ayah karima says that that will be akhirat. And in this dunya, you are still blind. For the simple reason that my messenger had come to you timelessly, giving you the message, believe in the oneness of Allah, believe in the creator that created this entire universe, and you kept on coming with excuses, you came with conditions, stating that for us in Makkah, we would want to see a fertile land. Would like to see an orchard of grape vines, etc. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in His knowledge, knows very well that previously the Anbiya Ikram were given mu'jizas. And the kuffar, just to make an excuse not to accept the message of the Anbiya Ikram, had put these conditions. The similar thing the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going through. And when they asked for these conditions to be put forward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ask them, are they blind? أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Don't they see that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created the skies? And it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created this beautiful earth. When you look around you, you see rivers flowing. You see the beautiful ocean. You see the beautiful landscape. Don't you ponder for a second or two to think, how did this come about? Obviously, naturally, these things didn't come about. There had to be a creator. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah karima says, remind the kuffar that it is I who had created everything that you see around you. And if you cannot see this, then you are blind. And in the day of Qiyamah, you'll be lifted up blind, you'll be lifted up deaf, you'll be lifted up dumb from your qabr. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then reminds the kuffar that as I created in the past, I'm able and capable to recreate. And Allah Ta'ala says, قَادِرٌ عَلَىٰ أَن يَخْلُقَ مِثْلَهُمْ. That I have the ability and I have the power of recreating you as you are in this dunya. Remember, insan has been created from dust. We have been created from clay. And it is Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala's power that from the very same dust, He had created components within yourself, certain organs that help you to see, hear, it helps you to feel, It helps you to eat, it helps you to taste. You have all these abilities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put within your body. And on the day of Qiyamah, before the time of resurrection, remember, every one of us, at least most of us, our condition will be in a form of dust. There'll be nothing that will be remaining. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as I've created you in the past, I have the ability to recreate you. And I'll make you resurrect in the very similar manner as you was in this dunya. The only difference is, it comes in the hadith, that the believers will have their faces full of noor. Their faces will be shining. As for the kuffar, they will have no noor, their faces will be darkened. And this will be a simple way to differentiate between the believers and the non-believers. That is the difference. But otherwise, as far as recognition, as far as feeling the pain, feeling thirst and hunger, you will have the very same abilities in you on the day of Qiyamah. In this dunya, how you feel thirsty, the very same condition will prevail within your body on the day of Qiyamah. Here, when it is 35, 40 degrees, we feel very, very hot. We don't know how many thousand degrees it's going to be on the day of Qiyamah. When the sun comes close to our head, we will be drowning in our own perspiration. That is the time, dear brothers, we'll have the very same feeling as we feel in this dunya. Then what is going to be the condition of the kuffar? Those that refuse to accept the propagation of our beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, remember, do not feel. Now this is addressed to the kuffar, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not feel that once you are dead, you turn into dust, then that is the end of you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah will resurrect you. For all that you did, going against the religion of Islam, going against the propagation of the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of that you will have to answer on the day of Qiyamah. Remember, the Jews and the Christians, they knew very, very well that the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the last and final messenger. And once two Jews came to the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they asked questions, and they knew that these questions no one else will answer besides the Prophet of Allah. And when they asked these questions to the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, can show us the nine signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. The beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam replied to them that the first one is, do not commit shirk. The second is, do not steal. The third is, do not commit adultery. The fourth is, do not kill anyone with zulm and cruelty. The fifth is, do not make jadu, black magic. The sixth one is, do not eat interest. And the seventh one is, that an innocent woman, do not accuse her. And the eighth one is, that at the time of jihad, at the time of battle, do not run away from the battlefield. And the ninth one is, do not take an innocent person and make him and blame him for something that he did not do. When the beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered these questions to them, they immediately kissed the hands of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they kissed the feet of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked them, are you not going to accept Islam? And they replied that no, we are afraid of our leaders. We are afraid of our nation, the Jews. what they are going to do to us. Now, how stupid they were, that they're not afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing very well both the Bible, the Torah, talks about Jahannam, talks about the punishment of Akhirah. Similarly, the Quran talks about the punishment of Akhirah. You're not worried about the punishment of Akhirah, you're not afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's azab, but you're afraid about your leaders, you're afraid about your nation. Brothers in Islam, when one recognizes the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when one gets recognition that is ma'rifat, then he shouldn't be afraid of anything. Once you have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then nothing is going to make you afraid. That is where the problem comes. That we are afraid of this dunya for the simple reason that we have forgotten Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been taken away from our heart. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُلُّ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي إِذَا لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ. The beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked to ask the kuffar Makkah that tell them that all the khazana, all the ni'mat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has in terms of rizq, in terms of wealth, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, if He gives it to you, O kuffar, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is what's going to happen. You will have all the riches, you'll have all the wealth, but you wouldn't want to spend a dime. That is insan. The more he gets, the more he wants to hoard. And the fear will come in his heart that what's going to happen if this money gets depleted? What's going to happen if all of this finishes? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ, that with the fear of everything finishing off, they would not spend a dime. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ قَتُورًا, that insan is the biggest miser. That is the kuffar. Alhamdulillah, the Muslims, we have been taught to give zakat. We have been taught to help the poor. We have been taught to make qurbani. We have been taught to help and assist the needy. And it is because of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiplies the wealth of the Muslims. Throughout the world you look at the Muslim. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had bestowed them with abundance of wealth. But the only sad thing is that those countries that have wealth in abundance, instead of helping the needy African countries, you find that this wealth unfortunately reaches the West. Unfortunately, it indirectly goes into the hands of the Israelis, who in turn are slaughtering our Muslims, the Palestinians. That is a sad part of it. Wealth Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed the Muslims. And alhamdulillah, wherever you go in this world, whether it is China, whether it is America, whether it is England, whether it is Europe, whether it is Africa, you will find masajids throughout the world. And these masjids have been built by faithful Muslims. They have been building these masajids. They have been spending money in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had rewarded them in abundance. That wealth hasn't come less. It increased. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the kuffar that if I gave you all the wealth, you would not spend. But this is addressed to the kuffar. But on the flip side, when you look at the believers, alhamdulillah, they have spent. They have learned from the Sahaba ikram. They have learned from the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to spend. And how too, dear brothers, When one looks at the example of Sayyidina Ali al-Murtaza radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Hazrat Fatima al-Zahra, then Hazrat Fatima al-Zahra, 3 days of hunger, when she tells Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, "Oh Ali, it's gone 3 days we haven't eaten." Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu goes into the jungle, he cuts wood, he spends half a day, he comes onto the marketplace, he sells that, he takes those few dinars, buys flour, he gives it to Fatima al-Zahra radiallahu ta'ala anha. She makes 2 bread. And at the time of supper, about to eat, a beggar comes knocking on the door and asks in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Hazrat Fatima al-Zahra take both the bread with starvation, hunger, gives it to the beggar. Now this is the lesson the Muslims have been taught by the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that give in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala haven't left us with nothing. The more we spend, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى تِسْعَ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ, that we have given Musa alayhi salatu wasalam 9 mu'jizas, 9 nishanis, 9 signs. But when he came to the Bani Israel with these signs, is جاءهم فقال له فرعون إني لأظنك يا موسى مسحورا. Pharaoh first looked at Musa alayhi salam. He says, "Oh Musa, you were the one that grew up in my palace. You went away from Egypt, and now you come back here and claiming to be the messenger of Allah." Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam showed them 9 signs where the azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came in a form of blood, in a form of lice, in a form of frogs. These were all the signs that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam produced to him. And he said, "But I see you as a magician." Eventually the story is long where he brought his magician. They were all defeated by Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. But remember, all the Anbiya Ikram, whenever they came onto this dunya, the believers accepted the message. It was only the kuffar that made excuses. It was the kuffar that asked for mu'jizas. But when a believer looked at the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or looked at the Anbiya of the past, just by looking at them, they accepted Islam and they did not ask for any mu'jizas. And we as believers, we are in this era that there is going to be no Nabi. And it is, in the past, it was forbidden to ask the Anbiya Ikram, "Show me a mu'jiza," unless the Anbiya Ikram produced the mu'jiza themselves, produced the miracles themselves. In this time and era, if anybody claims to be a Nabi, we have all the rights to ask the person for proof. Like Hazrat Pir Mehre Ali Shah, Rahmatullah Alayh, in his time, when Mirza Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani claimed to be a Nabi of Allah, Hazrat Pir Mehre Ali Shah challenged him. He says, "You are a liar. There can never be a Nabi after the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." And when he accepted the challenge, and remember, this was he was a friend of Allah. Hazrat Pir Mehr Ali Shah was a wali Allah. He was a friend of Allah. He says, "You Nabi Allah, come and prepare to challenge you." And Mirza Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani, well, the only one thing good about him, he was a very fast writer. He says, "Let's put the challenge on writing. Let's see who writes fastest." Hazrat Pir Mehr Ali Shah Sahib, in that morning when he got up, he dreamt about his murshid. Hazrat Khwaja Shamsuddin Ul-Arifin comes in his dream and he says to him, "Mehr Ali, put one extra condition and tell that person that it is not only about the fast writing, but you should give hukum to your pen and your pen must write." Pir Mehr Ali Shah Sahib was prepared to do that. When you put this condition, that is when Mirza Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani realized, now I can't challenge this man. And he left the place and he ran away. Now, for Hazrat Pir Mehr Ali Shah Sahib, it was permissible for him at that time to ask for a mu'jiza, to challenge that man. But as for the ummats of the past, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Anbiya Ikram, it was the duty for them to accept it. And it was only and only the kuffar that made accusations of this nature. They called the Anbiya Ikram that these are magicians. Some of them called the Anbiya Ikram that you are a human being just like us. Even Abu Jahl and the others stated to the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam that you are like a man just like us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا مَنَعَ النَّاسَ أَن يُؤْمِنُوا إِذَا جَاءَهُمُ الْهُدَىٰ. And what stopped the people from bringing iman? إِذَا جَاءَهُمُ الْهُدَىٰ, when guidance comes to them, when we send it in the form of Anbiya Ikram, إِلَّا أَن قَالُوا أَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ بَشَرًا رَسُولًا, that you have sent a man like us as a messenger of Allah. Dear brothers, the Sahaba Ikram never at any time called the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by his name. So much so, Hazrat Fatima al-Zahra, when she addressed her father, she could have said, oh my father, she always addressed the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Allah's Rasul. So this ayah kareema, dear brothers, teaches us that the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is everywhere. It was the kuffar that made the excuses, and it was the believers that accepted the message of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they accepted the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Allah's last and final messenger. They didn't doubt the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in any way. Dear brothers, it is for us to accept the Quran and the teachings of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a form of hadith. When somebody tells you this is the hadith of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it becomes our responsibility to accept it without a doubt, because this is the saying of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when it comes to the Quran, you cannot at any time reject any ayat for that matter, even one word. You cannot reject the Quran, because then you'll become a kafir. I make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a tawfiq of understanding the Quran and understanding the teachings of the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ma alayna illa al-balagh al-mubin.